Welcome, my fellow Model A Ford fans, to a free Ford Friday. Well, this is just kind of an idea. I thought I'd try this. So there's a lot of stuff that gets edited out of the normal Saturday videos that I put out every week, or maybe it just didn't make the cut, whatever. And I thought, you know, I need a place to put some of that stuff because it's too good to just let, you know, disappear. So I thought, what the heck, I'll try this. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Should we keep doing these or not? So figure Fridays, I'll throw in all that extra stuff, plus viewer mail too. So like Tina went to the post office box this morning and brought back all kinds of goodies that I wanna share with you. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna open the mail and show you everything everybody sent, read letters, and answer some questions, and also throw in some extra stuff. For example, a year ago when Tina and I went to the Ironstone Concours d'Elegance, we took the Sport Coupe. For that one, it was a tour. They didn't do it as a regular show where people come to the grass and look at cars. They did it as a tour. We ended up running into this really neat guy. His name was Rich Davis, and he had a real early VW Beetle. And once I started looking at his car really close, and he was very helpful and real open, and you know, it's like, this thing's practically a Ford Model A. It's like an air-cooled Model A in the simplicity, the way the thing is put together, and everything. I was really impressed. So I asked him, Mr. Davis, can I, you know, do an interview with you for this silly YouTube thing that I do? Do you mind? He said, no, he was really gracious and helpful, informative, and he had just had surgery. I like just had surgery, he was recovering. He wasn't feeling good. He says, do you mind if we get this over with kind of quick though? You know, I said, no, absolutely. So I rushed real quick. I put a microphone on me, put a microphone on him, set up a couple cameras real quick, record it, and the interview went fantastic. He was really helpful, showed us all the stuff, neat things about the car and all that. And then in my haste, it wasn't until I got home that I realized I'd never plugged the microphones into the camera. Complete fail. Luckily, one of the cameras had a built-in mic and the audio was terrible, but I didn't know what to do with it. I was just gonna, well, I'm never gonna get to use this now. But just for grins, I thought, well, maybe the audio, if I run it through some processing, maybe it'll be okay. So I went ahead and did that. I want to share it with you so much because this car was so neat, and you'll see the similarities between this early, early VW Beetle and the Ford Model A. And since I've thrown my back out and I can't really do anything in the shop right now except roll myself around here in my wheeled chair here in the shop, I figured I got to get something out that I want to, and I really wanted to share this with you, plus viewer mail. So let me cut to the interview with Rich Davis. Excuse the audio, please. The audio is atrocious because, like I said, the mics weren't plugged in. I want to roll that and share that with you. I wanted to share this with you for a year. I finally get to. I'm really glad to do that. And then when we come back from that, I'll start opening this viewer mail and sharing it with you. So here we go. Let's check this out.
I'm here with Rich Davis. Rich Yep. Davis owns a 1951 Volkswagen. And the reason why I'm spotlighting this car is because, for all intents and purposes, this is a Model A. It's just about 20 years newer.
Yes, so. It is. Yeah.
So Rich, tell us about this car. How'd you end up with this?
Well, 50 years in the Volkswagen business. I had a Volkswagen shop since 1967. So, definitely in it, family business. And so, a friend of mine was in England. He found this car and said, you ought to own it. And we ended up importing it from England. And then 1984, and we went through and restored the motor, and not the transmission, but everything is original. Other than that, the paint has been redone.
So you've repainted, but I noticed the wheels and some things look like they might be original.
They are. They are. Those are the original color. I kept things as best I could. The interior is patched together. I just recently found a guy in New York that was taking an old interior out, and I bought his old interior.
Perfect. Yeah.
Put patches in this to keep it going.
Hey, for some of the environmental types, that's recycling.
Recycling.
Nice.
Yes. Right.
So how much horsepower does this car have?
So we have 25 horsepower, four speeds forward, one reverse, and that's about it. Yeah.
And it's all mechanical steering, and but it has hydraulic brakes, right?
This one has hydraulic. Yeah. Yeah, the earlier ones, 49, has lever brakes, right. Okay.
So all in all, fuel economy, what kind of mileage is it?
That's a good question. Not very good.
Not very good?
Not very good. No, not very good. So we're probably in the 20s
Okay, well, compared to some of the other cars here at this event, that's pretty good.
Is that pretty good?
Yeah.
But you think Volkswagen, you know, small carburetor, 25 horsepower.
You just sip fuel, right?
Right, right.
Yeah, well, apparently not. So this thing must have some horsepower to it, right? well, 25, you got lots of torque, though, right?
Yeah, we do, until you hit a hill.
And then that's it.
That's it, yeah. One cool thing is our gas, Chris, open up the hood. Our, yeah, gas gauge. This is common tool. There's no gas gauge.
All right, okay. So if you're inside the car, you don't know how much gas you have until you open the trunk, I guess it would be?
Yeah, you have to stop.
Okay, so you have the fuel tank.
So huge cap.
Oh, right, I like this. Okay, good. That's a fail-proof fuel gauge.
Yeah, so.
Oh my goodness, look at that.
Yeah. There we go.
What's that, like 50 pounds right there?
Go ahead. You
could it's a good pound.
You could have it around your neck or something, you know?
Yeah, that's right. I could be like, what's the guy that wears the clock around his
neck?
Oh,
yeah. Yeah. Wrapper, yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, so one side's U.S. gallons.
Yes.
One side's liters.
Excellent. So, for those of us who cannot do the conversion.
Yeah.
Oh, you're hitting low.
Wow. Ooh.
You're going to make it home?
We're on reserve.
Yeah. It's a good thing we checked.
So that's 10 gallons for, what did we do today? 60 miles?
I guess you guys did, because you made the wrong turns.
Right, so.
We turned around.
Yeah.
We figured out that everybody was going the wrong way, so we turned around.
So anyway, maybe my 20 miles a gallon is not very accurate.
Yeah, well, it's a good thing is it's almost all downhill.
No, I got to go uphill.
Oh, you have to go up.
We're going up to Arnold.
Oh, good.
So original jack. 16-inch wheels.
So all in all, cruising speed for this car. Comfortable cruising speed without taxing it on a flat ground.
40 miles. No, 35-40 is...
35-40?
Yeah, that's not taxing it. That's cruising.
Until you hit a hill.
Then we're down to the 20-25.
Well, we were behind you for quite a bit of the tour, and you were moving right along. There
was
no problem.
Until we hit the hills. We had to pull over and go into first gear.
Because
it was nasty. There's no, you don't have synchros in yours.
No.
No. So we had to pull over and put it in gear and let the cars pass.
Sometimes
to catch up.
Well, that's what happens. You know, those of us who take life slowly.
Oh, that's right.
We're used to it.
We're used to it.
Thank you so much for sharing your car, Rich. That's really
nice.
Huh? See what I tell you? That is really a lot like the Ford Model A, and what a nice guy. Rich, thank you so much for doing that. I'm sorry it took me almost a year to finally put that together. So Tina went to the post office box. Thank you for everybody who's been sending goodies and letters. And so what I did is I checked with everybody to see if it'd be okay to share on the channel. And some people were like, yeah, that'd be fine. Go ahead and share. And some people are like, nah, I'd rather not. And I'm like, okay, fine. So I will respect your wishes. So we'll start off with this unassuming can. My friend Mike Kozad, who's been to my shop several times, and you've seen him in a couple of my videos. Mike came across authentic 600W lube, the actual stuff, and if you shake it, I mean, it sounds like thick paint in here, and he taped the top so there was no leaks and everything. And Mike ran across this. I don't know how you got this, Mike, but thank you for sending me a gallon of it. This is the actual lube that goes in the Ford Model A transmission and rear end. The 600W lube that the Model A suppliers sell now is, in almost everyone's opinion, including mine, a little too thin. So he found this stuff and sent me some. Thank you very much, Mike. I can't wait to put this in one of the cars, maybe this one. We'll see how it works. That's cool. Thank you. Next is a very thoughtful box of goodies by Rob Marcotte. And Rob sent this letter. Hi, Paul. Because of your work as an engineer in broadcasting, I kind of figure you're a ham radio operator. You guessed right. Confirmed it with your wife. Oh, okay. Well, my wife's, she's a tattletale. So his dad was W1 LTD, became a silent key, which means he passed on in his 50th year as a ham. Sorry to hear that. He was on the air the night before he died. Anyways, I kept his old key, which there's a Morse code key in here. Yep, thank you. Kept this old key in hopes of Sunday finding someone who appreciates old stuff. That would be me. So if you want this, keep it. If not, maybe you can find someone else who'd want it. Oh, I like this. Thank you. Searching for a steel roof closed cab pickup. I started watching your videos to better prepare myself for maintaining a Model A if I can find one. Your videos have given me good insight and what to look for. Thank you, Rob. Well, good for you, Rob. A late 31 steel top pickup. That's actually kind of what I'm looking for, too. So if I find two, I'll send one your way. Oh, he writes here in handwriting, As an afterthought, I'm sending you this Kenwood stuff. I hope it works. So, what Rob sent was a Kenwood mobile ham radio right here. And he sent a Kenwood portable radio right here. And I'll tell you what, Rob, I appreciate this very much. So, as some of you have seen in some of my videos, I carry one of those cheapo eBay, you know, Chinese-made hand portables in the Model A's. And they're garbage. Everybody knows they're garbage, but it's like, yeah, you know, it's cheap. What the heck, you know? And so I kept getting so much flack from my other ham radio buddies about having that cheapo radio. I put a Motorola sticker on it just to, you know, shut them up a little bit. But anyway, you know what? That radio is no longer riding in a Model A. This radio is the new radio that's going to be riding in the Ford Model A's every day. And that Kenwood mobile, it's going to go in the shop right here. I'm going to mount it in the shop. Finally, I'll have 2 meters in the shop. Thank you so much, Rob. That was so thoughtful. And I'm so sorry to hear about your dad, but I'm glad he was on the air the night before he passed. I can't think of a better way to go being on the air. Thank you so much, Rob. Man, this is going to be in a Ford Model A in about 5 minutes. Next up is this really nice handwritten letter from John Coffer. And John is a new Model A guy. He says, greetings, Paul. A couple years ago, I came across your latest Model A Ford YouTube videos about the daily driver. You're a good talker. Thanks. And your coupe is gorgeous. I never heard the word sordid in conjunction with a car. You're totally right about it, meaning I have 2 Model A's and 3 Model T's. Wow, good for you. And a lot of sorting has been done with them to make them reliable. Enclosed is a snapshot of my 29 pickup with my girlfriend by it. There he goes. Nice truck. Nice girlfriend. See, I did that right so that I don't get in trouble. Anyway, John writes that he doesn't have the finances to pay for a lot of the Model A and Model T mechanics doing work on his cars for him. You're always the best mechanic anyway. No matter what, you're going to be the best mechanic for your own cars. All my cars are insured by J.C. Taylor. It's antique. We drive them a lot. You know, pleasure drives. Wink, wink. This part of upstate New York is unmatched for that. Quiet backcountry roads. And so much like Calaveras. Anyway, what a great letter. Thank you, John. And thank you for the picture. Appreciate that very much. And thanks for watching. And man, that was really nice of you. Thanks. Next up is a really neat letter from a gentleman with a fantastic last name, Holden Ford. And he comes to us from Cedro Woolley, Washington, I think it is. He wrote this nice letter here. Oh, it's got pictures too. It says, hi, Mr. Shinn. I don't have a technical question, but I do have a question. I've been watching your channel for a while. Your videos are wholesome and awesome. Thank you. Let's see. I know you're a Model A guy, and Model T's are too old-fashioned for you. Not really. But I have a Model T. I would love to bring on your YouTube channel and be a guest on the show. It's an all-stock 26-27 four-door. I bought the car as a two-door in December. Buying a two-door and having a body swap proved to be more affordable. Man, that's a lot of work. After it's sat for years, apparently, he's done wiring and paint. He plans to have the car done by mid-June, do a test drive, and then drive it across the country, hitting California, Florida, New York City, and back home in Northern Washington. Wow. I'll be going all the way down California. Would like to meet you, see your cars, possibly be a guest on your channel. Sure, that'd be great. You could drive it around, compare it to your preservation four-door. Man, that'd be fun to compare the two cars side by side, wouldn't it? I thought I'd give you a plan ahead of time so you have time to give a thought about me. I'm 18. 18, guys. He's 18. You guys that say the hobby's dying out, look at Holden right here. He restores antique photographs, sewing machines, typewriters, which he did type this on an antique typewriter, if you can see that. Says his next car will probably be a Model A due to my enthusiasm and tight budget. I do almost all the work myself. Good for you. I'm old-fashioned with a flip phone and a laptop. Yes! Okay, another flip phone user. If you want to contact me, you can call me. Gave his phone number. And that's a great letter. So here's the pictures he sent. So he used his, looks like a 50s Chevy truck, and he was towing his Model T home on it. That was great. And then he also included a couple of printed out shots of the truck. Thank you so much, Holden. You know what? You bring enthusiasm to this, and we appreciate it. And yeah, absolutely. Come by and yeah, let's do a video collab together. When you're on your trip through, you're probably going to need to stop and, you know, oil changes and stuff anyway. My shop is your shop, my friend. Come on by. That'd be great. I'd love to have you on the channel, especially 18 years old and you're doing this. Yeah, you're a rock star. Awesome. Come on by. The last package that showed up in the mailbox is from Ryan Takeuchi. I hope I'm saying your name right, Ryan. He sent us a care package of goodies from Hawaii. Yes. And so a couple of these still survive. So we've got the cookies, the guava jam. I can't wait to try this. He sent, my favorite. He sent Oahu honey. I love honey so much. My wife just recently got bees because we like honey. And my favorite, yes, macadamias. And my wife is a coffee-holic. He sent coffee, and I want you to know, Ryan, she's already been into the coffee. It hasn't even been, what, a day and a half, and she's already into the coffee. She's a complete coffee junkie. And ooh, that smells good. And there were some other goodies, too, but Tina has already devoured those goodies. Ryan sent a neat letter and a little something or another. So Ryan sent this, which you guys probably have never seen this before. But check this out. So what this is an original in Hawaii. They used to have to get these stickers to put on your car. It's kind of like the stickers that were issued during World War II in the mainland, you know, for rationing and things like that. And Ryan wrote a letter here. Ooh, my back. So it's just something small for you. This letter, you'll find a 1963 Hawaii registration sticker. There are hot rodders who are making reproductions, but this one is an original and hard to find. It was the only year that had King... A king, it started with a K on the sticker, and it was placed on the passenger side front windshield. Thank you for the tips in your videos. Thank you, Ryan. You know, as it just so happens, I have a complete collection of those stickers from World War II, those ration stickers. And I was putting a display together, and this is going to become part of that display just because this is that impressive and important to me. Thank you so much. That's so kind. So anyway, everybody, that is a wrap. I need to go inside and ice this again. And don't worry, more videos are coming out. I will be back on my feet, and we're going to be doing some more work on the Model A's. Thank you again so much for watching and for subscribing. I'll catch you on the next video as I wheel myself back to the house.